So when people run for office, there are topics that they tend to focus more of their time on. It might be the committee that you serve on, it might be an interest area, it might be somebody who touched your heart when you ran for office. And for me, on the very first day, actually the first day that I ever, or the first bill that I ever got signed into law by Governor Doyle was an expansion of a school in Racine. So for me, trying to make sure that we have the absolute best education system in the entire country has always been a priority. Now, we have great public schools, and this bill today makes a historic investment, as Senator Lemmy, who said, over $1 billion in new revenues for public schools all across the state. But it also makes a historic investment in the schools that are an alternative for some of the parents who believe that the public school that their kids go to isn't providing the education that they need. We are lucky in Wisconsin that we have an incredibly robust school choice system, where parents get the opportunity to choose between two public schools. They might choose to go from Mequon to Thienesville, or they might choose to go now in Wisconsin from a public school to a private school, and that might be the best option for their families. We have seen for a while that there's been this consternation, especially among some of my friends on the left, where they haven't been able to support those alternatives. Well, I am proud today to thank Governor Evers for the leadership that he is working with us to have the largest investment in public dollars in private school choice in the history of the state. That is something that we should all be really proud of. So under the old formula, if you remember, there's an amount in the statutes where a K-8 school receives and a high school receives and a charter school. Each of them are different. Under the bill that we have before us today, a K-8 school will be able to have $9,500 per pupil, a charter school will be $11,000 per pupil, and a high school will be $12,000 per pupil. Now, the good news for Wisconsin taxpayers is that every one of those numbers is still less than the amount that we spend in any public school in the state. But the good news for the parents who want a different choice is they are going to have more resources to make sure that for the kids who need a different school and the parents who want another alternative, they're going to have the resources to keep those schools as great as they are today. We also know that for an awful lot of parents, they are challenged by what's been going on in our school districts in general. So this number that we are putting forward today also has a huge investment in increasing the reimbursement rate for special education. We will increase the reimbursement rate for special education by $97 million. That's on top of the $1 billion that we are investing in the per pupil increase. In addition to that, we also have pledged to put $50 million into the literacy program that I think Senator Strobel is going to talk about, he did earlier today, to be able to continue the good work that's there. So I know that we are not at the end, but it certainly is a great step forward, and that's why I'm proud of the work that we are going to have this huge investment in school choice, and that's why I'm going to turn it over to Senator Strobel, who will comment on the same.
Very good.